Hey there, my name is Dan Scott, and this is one video from my larger Adobe XD course, which you can check out on bringyourownlaptop.com. You can also go there to download the free exercise files and the free cheat sheet if you like. All right, enjoy the video. Hey there, welcome to the best video in this whole course. Okay, it's about the repeat grid. I love the repeat grid. It's got a lame name. It should have a super exciting name, but it doesn't. Okay, and what it does is you draw something once and it just repeats on forever. Look at that. Okay, same with these. We're gonna make this course list and it shrinks and contracts and just keeps adding more and more forever. So good, I love it. Let's go and learn how to do it now in this video. Okay, so we're gonna be using the repeat grid on our dashboard here. Okay, so we're gonna draw out a box for our, where are we going? I'm gonna grab the rectangle tool, and I'm gonna draw out a box roughly about that sort of size, because I'm gonna have kind of like three stacked across, and I'm gonna add a bit of dummy text. I'm gonna type in stats, and I'm gonna use my character style. Okay, I might actually use the 16 for this one. Okay, so it's gonna have stats, and there's gonna be a number in the middle. What kind of number? I'm not sure yet, so probably dollar sign to start with. I'll put in 40,000. This is gonna have things like the monthly recurring revenue, how many visitors on the site, how many sales this month versus last month, all sorts of dashboardy stats. So I'm just gonna put this in. Trying not to design it, trying not to. Okay, so just some basics. So you, and there needs to be a little bit of explanation text in the bottom thing. I think I'll steal that from the homepage. This will just describe what's going on in this particular tile. All right, there we go. Paste. Yes, that looks beautiful. It's going to go in the middle. They're all going in the middle. Let's do that. Let's even select them all and do it properly, Dan. Okay, so we've got our tile. Actually, there needs to be like a little see more button. Okay, so we're gonna add a little plus probably in this top corner here, so you can kind of click. I'm not sure if it should be the three little dots, okay, or the nav sandwich. Now, probably not sure. We'll decide in user testing. So I've got my tile, so I'm gonna select all of these parts. Okay, and this is the magical button here, repeat grid. It should be called, I don't know, something more amazing, the amazing button or something. So I click on this and look what happens. Magic, it just kind of like duplicates it, which is cool, but it's even more awesome. Look at that. Okay, so I'm not sure how many of these we're gonna actually have, so I'll do this many. So the things you can do to do adjustments is you can obviously see these pink things appearing between the lines. Okay, I can drag those out to expand them or contract them. You can go negatives. Okay, so they're actually looking okay the way that they were before. So I'm gonna leave them like that. So the repeat grid will obviously duplicate them. But what gets nice is I can grab the type tool and it can actually make these quite unique. So this one might be 50K, okay? So it might be to do with the numbers. Now you can adjust, see that I could adjust the numbers, okay? I'm gonna actually make that centered. So I'm gonna grab that and make them all centered, okay? But if I start physically moving them, they're all connected. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. I get to go through and actually put in different kinds of data because I'm just to kind of represent the different things. And I have full control over, like, if I want to delete the plus button, I just delete it off one and they all delete. If I add one, okay, if I decide that I actually want to add a little thing to this guy, you'll notice that they all get it. Repeat grid is awesome. Okay, and we'll leave that there. And I want to show you one last amazing piece of feature for the repeat grid. Is that you can work with images as well. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna build our courses page, which is the next page on this list. And actually what I'm gonna do is that I'm going to just speed it up because it is nothing new, okay? I'll just make a new page and build out the first element. So let's speed through this. Okay, Taylor, take it away, speed it up, and I'll see you when we're done. Okay, so here we are on our kind of course page. So I'm going to select everything. I am going to go to repeat grid. And just like we did with the trainer thing, I'm still amazed by this. Every time I use it, it's amazing. So let's say we've got this many courses, right? The image thing I was referring to now is probably my most exciting thing to show anyone. And I'm actually in our exercise files. I'm in images and I've found all our course images. I've selected them all. Okay, and the easiest way is to be able to see the Finder window, or if you're on a PC, have the window open and just drag it in from there into any of these blue squares. Ready for the magic? Oh my goodness, that is magic. Okay, I am super excited by that. Goes through and just kind of replicates them all the way through. Okay, yeah, I love it. Repeat Grid, it's XD's magic weapon. Okay, and it means that I can still have like a bit of control, remember? Okay, I can select on here and I can find my grids here and I can open and close these, say that I want these all kind of like banged up together or maybe just a little bit apart. Okay, I've got a little bit of adjustment. And say this checklist here, I need to go and change this to the black or the gray. Okay, easy to go and update. Now, can you do it with text? Yes, you can, okay? So in your example file, you just need a text file, okay? Like this one here, it's got a bunch of names in there. And you just gotta make sure it's either a .txt or RTF file, just something really basic, nothing that has any formatting like Word, okay, or a PDF. So just a plain old text document, and then you just click, hold, and drag the actual document itself across one of the titles, and bingo. How cool is that? So I love repeat grid, and I couldn't leave it later in the course, especially these images, because it's just too special. But for this actual wireframe, we're getting too detailed in, okay? So I'm gonna have to go through and undo to get rid of all these images, okay? And go back to where it was just all plain Jane. I should probably go remove this word here and just put in sample course. All right, so that is it for repeat grids. I love them, but you are probably sick of me going on about them. Let's go on to more of the awesomeness in XD in another video. Hey there, please like the video. Consider subscribing to my YouTube channel as well. If you want the full course for Adobe XD, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. That's it. Bye now.